Back, buckle up and take a deep breath. We're taking you on a time travel trip back to the 60s. The psychedelic era may be making a return trip to your neighborhood soon, so pay attention to today's inside story and be prepared. In the late 60s, psychedelia was a swirl of color with bands like Jefferson Airplane, Cream, the Strawberry Alarm Clock. Even established superstar groups like the Beatles and the Rolling Stones went psychedelic. Together, they helped ignite a youth movement that took its inspiration from anti-war protest and drugs. Lots of drugs, principally LSD. And the psychedelic style was born. Now, the 90s are seeing a resurgence of psychedelia. This is no acid flashback. It's actually the latest music video from a New York dance band called Delight. And other groups are following suit. Out of Sweden comes a band called The Creeps. Out of England, Candy Flip. And out of San Francisco, where it all really started back in the 60s, some self-styled hippies with the name Jellyfish. However, the 60s explosion is also showing signs of turning mainstream.
This is a fabulous 60s outfit, but it's really a 90s outfit.
Psychedelic fashions are turning up on the TV talk show circuit, as in this segment of Sally Jesse Raphael. It's a look that revives the fun of 60s chic with the flair of flower power. San Francisco-based designer Roberto Robledo is uncovering the trend in his latest line of clothes.
Hot pants, bell bottoms, very wide headbands, beehives, big loop earrings, and color.
And some of those same fashions were played out again for real just this past weekend in Los Angeles. Hundreds of fans flocked to a revival of music performed by time-honored 60s bands Buffalo Springfield Revisited and Spirit. At the festival, tie-dyed t-shirts were all the rage. However, drug use was nowhere in evidence. That was heartening to one parent who's happy to see psychedelia return, but without the LSD.
A lot of the kids that are dressing this way and listening to this music, they watch their parents. They don't need it. But they still can have that feeling, and it's great. They love it.
And despite the turbulent times that went along with flower power, a youthful t-shirt vendor sees it this way.
It was a good time, and we're jealous that we didn't get to live through that time, I think. And we wish we were there. It seemed like a really cool time to live. Strawberry fields
forever. Much of that nostalgia goes all the way back to the Beatles. Their song, Strawberry Fields Forever, is considered to be one of the earliest expressions of 60s psychedelia. Today, the teenagers from Candy Flip have revamped the Beatles classic with their own updated version. And they've turned it into a hit for a whole new generation. While at the same time, the boys in Jellyfish are bringing back psychedelia with their throwback 60s outfits. However, these guys claim that no matter where they go, they're actually slightly ahead of their time, even when they're just out having fun. And according to lead vocalist Andy Sturmer, the psychedelic look is set to invade neighborhood shopping malls across the USA.
Within a few years, you'll go into the Macy's Tiger Shop and you'll see all the stuff that we're wearing now, you know, but it'll take a little while. We're just, you know, we're just here first.
No tie-dyes and bell-bottoms on display at the big clothing chains just yet. Those return to the 60s bands have been buying their stuff at secondhand stores and robbing their parents' storage closets. On our inside story tomorrow, Anita Bryant had it all until she took a very public stand against homosexuals. Her cause virtually destroyed her career.
I remember lying in the bed in my mother's house in a fetal position and wanting to die and afraid that if I took my own life, I'd botch that up too.
Anita Bryant, down but not out, struggling to start over. Our inside story tomorrow on Entertainment Tonight.